All right, guys, we are at the San Onofre campgrounds. We're gonna go in San Onofre State Beach. We're gonna go take a look at the nuclear power plant that's just on the road here. They're actually in the beginning stages of dismantling the reactor cores because it's been inactive for some time. They did have some problems with this one before, it's now non-functioning. So they're going to tear it down. It's a pretty iconic landmark here in Southern California, just on the southbound 5. You can see it off to the right by the beach. It's a little bit of a walk down here. Not too far, a quarter mile or so. So this is all technically, I think, still part of Camp Pendleton. And no, at least the east side, the enjoyment of this park, courtesy of the U.S. Marine Corps, in partnership with the state of California, please help preserve Camp Pendleton's natural resources. Okay. So, technically, part of the base, at least this, has all those hills on the east side of the freeway. All people for sure. So anyway, it's considered San Onofre State Beach in partnership with Camp Pendleton Marine Corps. Anyway, so once we get down there, let's get some more. All right, guys, this is the south side of the city. This right back there, camera. And they have several loudspeakers, sirens, I suppose, if there were ever some type of accident here in the future. But we need to get some warning out to the populace. And that's one of the issues with this place. Even after they dismantle the reactors, they still have, I'll have to link the article in the description. They still have 55 million gallons or 55 million of nuclear waste stored underneath of this facility. And in all the articles that I've read, they're inadequate containers, subject to saltwater corrosion and erosion, which is where they're being stored. So it's still a potentially very dangerous area to all of the Southern California region. And nobody will take it. They've been trying for years and years to get other places, other states to accept it, bury it out in the desert, you know, North Dakota or Arizona or someplace like that has very remote, unpopulated areas. And, you know, to them, I guess they want to subject their own populace to this kind of nuclear waste. But that's the real issue with this for generations to come. They don't ever find some place to take it or some other method to store it, it could potentially be a very bad situation. Because it's stored right by the water, right by the ocean. We're just walking on the bike path in front of the facility here. coming up to the south gate at the stoplight. Some of you might remember the more famous reference to this particular facility comes in a movie called Naked Gun, Leslie Nielsen, where he's driving along the 5 freeway here, headed to San Diego, and sees this kind of at night. At night they have 2 red lights on each of the globes of the domes, and he says that everything I see reminds me of her lamenting the fact that he lost his girlfriend, which is, I think, Priscilla Presley in the movie. But yeah, that's the more famous reference. Southgate, and there was some notice beginning on the north side that the south gate was closed. Probably not a security guard. But you can see the domes in the background there. Songs, South Gate, 5000 Pacific Coast Highway, San Clemente. There's a guard in there. Warehouse phone. Instructions. The unlawful authorized introduction of any dangerous weapon, explosive, or other dangerous instrument, or material likely to produce substantial injury or damage to persons or property into or upon these premises is a federal crime. Well, hello. You have 55 million gallons or barrels of potentially harmful substance sitting right underneath of you. There's a sidewalk here. What's all in all these containers? A lot of stuff. I don't know. I think bulk. Thank you. some type of cleaning equipment. They still have these huge power lines coming from inside processing plant. We go up and over across the freeway into Kentucky. Moving south. But those are the atomic nuclear reactor bombs. Like sooner than three. Friendly wave, passerby. So we made it down to the north gate here. You see, it goes off here to the south. Proper ID, permission to enter or be on SCE property, including parking lots, just upon request, consent to search of all individual vehicles or individual effects. Searches authorized, searches by authorized company representatives may be made of any locker, storage area, vehicle, individual or individuals' effects on site at any time without further prior announcement, and may employ electronic search devices or trained search dogs when appropriate. Firearms, explosives, incendiary devices, and all other weapons are prohibited on site. No active law enforcement and military personnel are exempt if possession is required and/or related to on-the-job response. Unlawfully possess drugs or drug paraphernalia and alcoholic beverages are prohibited on site. Note, resident campers must follow the requirements set forth in SSSPG-SO123-G-3. Possession or the use of alcoholic beverages or unlawfully possessed drugs, drug paraphernalia, or other prohibited items at the San Onofre site, including the Mesa facilities and all parking lots, is forbidden. Again, stating that same SSSPG, whatever that is. Vehicles parked illegally or subject being towed without notice at one's expense. Rules and regulations, Sun Central Processing Facility. So there are bike trails along this highway, as you can see, bike trails up and down the coast. You're also able to go on Camp Pendleton, but you have to have a pass. It's a non-military visitor pass. You have to go and show them your ID and all that, and then you can. It's like a bike pass, and then there's certain bike paths that you can use on Camp Pendleton to get through this area all the way through. Because Camp Pendleton goes on the east and west sides of the freeway. And then you can get on into Oceanside and further south once you get past there. But you have to get permission through the military. Employee concerns programs are here for you. How about concern that I'm going to get cancer? You're working around all these nuclear waste products. There's got to be some of that concern. In the background. The gate. Can you call this? Track that goes from here to LA. Here to timeless security site tower down there. It's a huge facility though, so all that stuff down that way, but apparently, if you look further down this way, you see these blue towers down there. It's about a 2-mile stretch from the entrance to this road off the freeway down to the campsite, and most of it is, let's say, 4/5 of it is covered by this facility. haven't seen the back on there. You have big cranes set up. You see those things are set up to move. Excuse me. They're set up to move those big Connex boxes. So they have the ability to pull whatever ship into that area, I suppose. Drop off. What's behind that sign? But drop off containers and move them back up onto trucks to position further wherever on the property, I guess. But it definitely goes all the way to the sea. Fenced off to the north here. You see, it's very close to the freeway. I mean, it's 100 yards the most. But not much activity around here for them starting the dispatching process. There's a lot of employee cars here, but maybe those are all employees for the north section of this facility. Let me shuttle them down there. Anyway, I think that's pretty much it. Like I said, I'll link the description. I'll link the an article, if not a couple, in each. So you can read up on what they're actually doing here. But this is more or mostly just to come out and get a look at it before they tear it down. Because once it's down, we'll forever change the landscape, so to speak.